I'll start with the Bible, Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 18. Ecclesiastes 7:18. It says, "It is good that you grasp this, and also not remove your hand from the other. For he who fears God will avoid all extremes." What does that mean? Apo juu inaongea kuhusu usiwache anything. Like, it is good ushike hii. Those are the benefits. But it's also good in our context to be aware of the effects so that you avoid all extremes, so that you don't get addicted. But also, we are not saying you don't go online, because if you don't, the world will leave you behind. I'll give an example. Nokia kitambo ilikuwa very big in Kenya and in Africa. Mbona walikuwa overtaken by Huawei, by Samsung, by nani? Senye, the technology inaitwa Android. Our phones are called Android. It's either Android or iOS, enye ni iPhone. Senye Android ilitokea, ilikuwa a new invention, wali approach Nokia kwanza. Kwenda na Nokia, Nokia wakawambia, "As we don't need your technology, we already doing well enough." So these guys went to all the other tech companies, wakawaonyesha, and they took it up. Ipo ndio Nokia waliachwa nyuma. Sasa saizi, about 2 years ago is when they are trying to come back and put in Android phones, but tushazoea Samsung, tushazoea Huawei, sasa ni ngumu sana warudi market because of being left by a technology. So it's important for you to be in line with the times, but don't get addicted. That's what it is telling us. A righteous man avoids all extremes. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 25, that is 1 Corinthians 9, 25, inasema, "And everyone who competes for the prize is temperate in all things." Everyone who competes in the prize is temperate. Temperate just means you are still avoid all extremes. You go by the rules and you don't get overtaken by emotions ama kitu kama hiyo. So the same thing. We need to, if we are to live righteous lives, we need to avoid all extremes. Now, these things that we're going to talk about are more of a challenge to me and my generation, especially me, because I'm sasa job yangu iko hapo kwa social media. So how do I create discipline and itafanya ni draw the line between addiction and work? So it becomes even more, and I need even more discipline than usual. And this is a challenge of every young person today. So nataka tuongee science kidogo, scientifically, and I want us to talk about our brain kidogo tu, and then we are going to go after the effects, we are going to go to the what we do, the tips for parents. So a study was done, wakaangalia cab taxi drivers wa London. You know, they have to operate very fast. It's a big city, unaweza potea haraka sana, kila kitu inafanana. And then, lazima uone mtu akifanya hivi ndio usimame wa mbele. So they fight for customers. So taxi drivers of London, a study was done on their brains. Na ikaonekana that in their brain, the prefrontal cortex. Okay, I want to show you the diagram here. Here, posterior hippocampus. Hiyo green part ilikuwa bigger than a normal human beings in the brain. So over time of being a taxi driver, that part of their brain, inaitwa posterior hippocampus, ina expand. Lakini hapo mbele penye kuko gray, kuna anterior hippocampus. So hii ki expand, of course, inafinya hii ingine. So posterior hippocampus, kazi yake ni nini, wacha tuone. It helps us benefits ya annual cataries. The posterior, hiyo yenye expand, is responsible for memory, so wanaweza kumbuka places, spatial ama geographical navigation. So ata uwaite wapi, atajua kufika huko. And also, cognitive functions. Hizo ni kama the skills needed to acquire knowledge, manipulating of information na reasoning. So hizo vitu zote zimegrow for them, because they are your posterior imekuwa kubwa. The anterior also has work, so it mediates anxiety related behavior. So mtu akiwa anxious, hiyo ndio way inakusaidia ku handle anxiety, hiyo anterior yenye imekuwa ndogo. It is also responsible for decision making, emotion and stress control. So that tells me that these people are very good at finding locations na nini, but they are bad at emotional controlling their emotions and stress. And so that's not a good thing. But I want to introduce a concept in it, was survival for the busiest. So your mind is a very incredible. It's the most complex thing on earth. Nobody has been able to understand it. And it ukifanisha one part of the brain kazi sana, hiyo ni haifanishi kazi kwa ina and achieve. So you need to make your brain active in all places. When you play music, for example, when you're playing an instrument, the brain in a light up in many places. Hiyo inamaanisha ina activate so many places in your brain, and that's good because it's in a grow balanced. But when you are doing, like being on your screen, there are some places in your brain that shrink as ngumu sana kuzirudisha active. And so, survival for the busiest. The busiest parts of your brain survive, and those others kind of die off, okay? Prolonged internet use imekuwa linked to reduction in white matter. Okay, I want to show you what white matter is. Iyo inaka kama minyongoro tuseme. All of those coins hapa juu, kifungua brain unaonanga coins, that is gray matter. Chini ya gray matter kuna white matter. White matter is very, 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 very vital because white matter is responsible for, it's like a superhighway. Think about a superhighway. So white matter is superhighway kama hiyo. All the information and inaenda kwa gray matter hiyo ya juu, ni hiyo ina transmit. Hii wate yende kunyuma ni ya macho. Hii yende huku kwa masikio. Hii yende hivyo hivyo hivyo. So white matter is that important. Hakuna kitu inaweza pita in your brain bila kupitia hapo. And prolonged use of the internet, mtu ana use too much, huwa ina reduce white matter. So that means your brain doesn't function at optimal position, and that's dangerous for everything you can think about for life. Okay? So hiyo ni superhighway. Unlike gray matter, white matter huwa inaendelea ku grow hata mtu akiwa middle age. Middle age I think ni kama 40 years if I'm not wrong, around there 30-35, that is when it grows mbaka. So that means even mine is still growing, but the gray matter, neuromaturation, yani when your brain matures, it matures at 25 years old. So you are a legal adult at 18, lakini your brain matures at 25. So that tells you why teenagers wanapenda ku take risks. They are very careful about peer influence and peer pressure because they want peer approval because of their mind is not working at optimal, when in a self-control. So they don't have that as much as an adult because bado hawajafika mpaka wafike 25. So smaller volumes of the white matter can cause memory, long-term memory in a reduce. Kuna vitu hautaweza kumbuka za kitambo. Attention span yako in a reduce. You can't pay attention for long. Intelligence and academic achievement is also reduced with the reduced white matter. And what else? Executive functions, these are self-control, problem solving, planning, kukua na to-do list, and then executing those plans and understanding consequences. So all of these things are not active baka teenager akue young adult at 25. So that is why, explains a little bit why they act the way that they act. So that is a bit about your white matter. Too much internet reduces it, and you see how important it is.